Shalom, shalom, shalom. How are you doing, brothers and sisters? We're here week 9 in our Hebrew and Bible Academy. First and foremost, we must give all praises to the Most High, Ahayah, in the name of Yeshaya, for another day. Another day living under Babylonian Roman rule, but nonetheless, closer to the kingdom of heaven. I want to say shalom to all of you. I hope the Most High has uplifted your spirit. And you know what? One thing that's good about this academy that I like, that I really respect and thank the Most High for, because I thank him for this also, is the fact that from week to week, we get an opportunity to share and to uplift the spirits of our people. And that's a very, very humbling position that the Most High placed us in, to be some level of beacon of light through the Holy Spirit on earth with our brothers and sisters, to open our eyes and keep our eyes open, and to also extend a spirit of trust that we must have one amongst each other. I noticed that I was thinking about this morning when I get up. The Most High always give me these things. And I'm like, you know what? How can you keep people servants? How can you keep brothers and sisters in a servitude attitude? Well, set up a system in which they inherently have no trust for each other. That's how you do it. No relationships can stay without trust. No foundation can operate. No successful company can operate without trusting. And it's deep, because I, at one point, and I thank the Most High for shedding this light on me, that at one point, you know, I would feel a certain type of way about when people would look to attack and do certain things against the church and myself and others. But then I have to realize the world we came from, where no one can do anything unless there's some ulterior motive or an agenda or a game behind it. So because our people have been trained to not trust, we can expect some of that. And whether it be right or wrong, usually it's wrong. But all in all, we don't even realize that we are perpetuating a slavery mentality by not trusting each other. Unless someone personally does something to you, personally, we're not supposed to look at anyone in a negative manner unless they have personally harmed you. And see, and that's one thing I've learned. You understand, like, well, listen, people are going to have scenarios and situations in which they argue, fight, bicker, whatever the case may be. Spirits come in, cause division. But I cannot feel a certain type of way about another brother or sister that didn't do anything to me. No one can get mad at me if I don't take on someone else's banner against a brother or sister. Okay? And it's not that I'm taking sides. If the person did nothing to me, didn't cheat me, hurt me, harm me, that's not my banner. So I'm usually the person to say, well, listen, you got to do what Christ said and go to that person. Don't get mad at me now and be in allegiance with against me, because I'm not in allegiance with you against another brother or sister. See, the Most High is not like that with us. He don't take sides. A matter of fact, he more so on the side of the lowly. Those that are, that you don't really think he's on their side. Sometimes when people are a certain type of way, or something is wrong that we can perceive as wrong, we have to realize and think of the things that led them to this, because we're born in a system of non-trust.
Right.
So when I woke up with this morning and prayed about it, I'm like, you know what? I'm going to make sure by day to day that I'm not influenced at all by someone else's experience. It's not my experience. Okay? Because I want to break that cycle of non-trust we have amongst our people. We need to give each other chances. You understand? And that's why when Peter asked Christ, well, how many oughts should a brother have against you and you shall forgive him? 7 times? At least give us a number.
Right.
Like a brother, You understand? Seven times is, you know, he know he's doing wrong now. Because the Most High always operate in cycles of seven, right? Right. And he forgive debts in the 7 years of Jubilee. So I know that Peter was asking that question with that in mind. Like, at least all things are forgiven every 7 years. So someone doing an art once a year and I forgive him in the seventh year, is that okay? He says, no, 77 times seven, multiply. Why? Because Christ knew that we would be a people going into captivity without law, being taught to only trust those who oppress us. He knew that we would have aught against each other. Not because we hate our brothers and sisters. Why? Because the authority thrives on our non-trust for each other. You understand? So we should operate and work with that, brothers and sisters, and know that if someone didn't personally do anything to you, you cannot take on someone else's banner against a brother or sister. The Most High don't like it. The Most High, he loathed that. Because why? He forgive us. Okay? So that's the key thing. Never take on a banner of non-trust based on someone else's observation. You don't know if they're operating. And 9 times out of 10, they're operating with an evil eye. No one have did anything to them, but they'll attack or try to put out something or try to hurt you and then want you to stand on their side against someone else. The Most High put that on my spirit to say, you know what? We have to mend those fences of trust going forward. And understand that the majority of people that will come into this truth are broken with trust issues. And that will be perpetuated amongst us. But we still must forgive each other and guide each other through that. That's the spirit of Christ. That's the spirit of healing and forgiveness. You understand? And that's what the Most High want for the children of Israel. He want that for his people. So I wanted to put that out there real quick. Before, I know we were in the Academy news, but, you know, sometimes when the Spirit brings us, you know, into these classes, it comes right after the Most High have given us some understanding to impart. All right. Or to share, because it's not just a learning experience for you, brothers and sisters. It's a learning experience for us also. We're growing together. We're all children of the Most High. Just remember that. I'm still the child of the Most High. So are you. You understand? So we need to start practicing that and correcting that non-trust authority have made. It's a slavery mechanism. Automatically, where the husband don't trust the wife don't trust the husband. And guess what? Even if something happened in which we had aught with each other, that would build non-trust. That would also make you feel that, oh, can I trust this person again? We must examine that too. We must really, really focus on that forgiveness. And when I look at Christ at Calvary on the cross, one of the last things he spoken, statements he spoke before the people, before our people, when everyone was bashing him and hitting him and stabbing him and hurting him, he says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Why? Because he was here for them. His crucifixion was prophesied to heal the nation. You understand? So when we are bickering at each other, fighting against each other, rumoring on one another, attacking each other, the Most High don't look on that as righteous at all. And it is not, and I noticed that some people try to cover their guile by claiming it's what the Most High would like them to do. No, the Most High wants you to forgive. That's what the Most High wants you to do. He wants you to forgive. Okay. With that, we're going to go into the news program. We're here week 9, right? Wow. Oh, man, how time fly when we're having a spiritual time. Okay. But, hey, If it be the Most High's will, we'll be right back with another one. But we have about 3 more weeks. Today, what lesson are we going into? The split between Israel and Judah. Now, today, we're going to cover that from a different angle. We're going to cover the split between Israel and Judah with the understanding of through our split, all 12 tribes was once one nation in Israel. But through our split, there were a non-trust was developed between Judah and Israel. To the point where we believe that those people that are of the northern kingdom are not our people. And they believe that we are another nation too. That we're just some black people from Africa. So we're going to cover that angle with that non-trust element as the foundation so that we can heal our nation as Christ would like. But without any further ado, right? Don't forget, stay tuned for the split between Israel and Judah. I'm going to hand it over to Brother Shapat for the news. One moment.